Day 3. I'm actually going to take a look. So you'll notice that this is the Forest of Hope from the first game. The layout is the same. But I think what I'm going to do is, I actually think your progression on day 3 is fairly railroaded, so I might just go in order. Apart from getting the white Pikmin early. Well, not just any ship. Purple Pikmin just completely break this game. Because not only do they home in on enemies, they stun them as well. There we go. I'm so great. Thank you. Maybe so. It is very fun. How much of it I tend to do varies. There's so much stop and go from the cutscenes at the beginning of this game. I guess I'll put all of them on this. No reason not to. Here's our other game-breaking item. And basically what that will do is it supercharges your Pikmin. Maybe. Anyway, yeah, you're not supposed to be able to get that early. I guess I'll do the cave first. Yeah, like the first game, the sound design in this is very good. And hopefully we'll be seeing less resets. Once again, thanks to the utter game-breaking power of the purple Pikmin. Yeah, even in the first game, they can't really do anything. I always found these metal areas interesting. Unfortunately, yeah, neither do I. Because it's just like a huge, hollowed out chasm, really. You look at the background. That's convenient. I think it's a later cave that I'm thinking of, but there's an area like this that has a, fiery bulblax. Which are a real pain in this game. For some reason, in Pikmin 3, they made the blowhogs lighter. Instead of 7, you need to... Yeah. The spray does make them a lot easier. But I don't usually tend to stock up on the sprays. Probably should, but I don't. It's a bit easier in Pikmin 3, because they'll automatically go back to the plants. I I think it's the same cave that the man at legs is in. I've always liked the rest area music. Can't really hear it, unfortunately, but it's very pleasant. If there's an exploit to get more Pikmin from this cave as well. Let's see. White flower garden. So they won't appear if I have more than 20. I was hoping I could get mostly leaves. Oh well. That's good to know. I don't know if I said it earlier, but I was thinking it. The reason I don't do a lot of swarming is just because I can more carefully choose the amount of Pikmin I want to put on different tasks. Somewhere around here. I'm sorry if my constant changing of the camera angle is nauseating. Thank you. That should be all of them. Now, if I'm correct, there is... Yes, there's a buried treasure. That was quick. How many floors does this cave have? 5. Yeah, and then they just make use of the white Pikmin gimmick straight away. Which is that they can breathe poison. Yes, that is very true. Neat little puzzle, I suppose. I guess I got everything. How large this floor is, you'd think there'd be more to it. There aren't even enemies. I forget what the boss of this cave even is. Oh, it's just a burrowing snaggret. They're supposed to be eggs, right? A little stingy, the spray, huh? Great time for a cutscene. Easy. The sound effect for the bitter spray is a burp, isn't it? How many people are watching? I continue to pull a fair amount of viewers, so thank you for everyone who's watching. I'm trying to remember if lying down as a captain makes you invincible in this game. I think that's think that only works in the first game. Something I might do. Is go back through that cave. Just to, just to get more white Pikmin. There's another poison gate. Wonderful. Of course I get that the first try. Just because I'm so good. Word there, slow. That was a lot of berries at once. Something I've actually got to stay on top of this time is having enough red Pikmin. To use for flowers. put them away. Just because I won't need them. Finished with that wall, so that's good. Gonna go ahead and make these return trips. I should have 34 after doing this. Now you may notice that the layout for both of these floors has been a little different. Yes, that's very good. But, most of these cave layouts are randomized. You know, it probably has. I mean, there are very few floors that aren't. Yeah, the female sheer corrupts basically just exist to be annoying and nothing else. Excuse me. Almost forgot. Well, I did forget. Now, since finishing this game will probably take a lot of time, I will try and edit and upload the individual parts in a more timely manner. How's the audio sync? Right. I would have been really upset if just one of them missed it. Yeah, that's another thing they improved from the first game. But it's actually the best in 3. Because they won't drink all of it if it's just one. What is 61 minus 25? Well, I won't need 34 white Pikmin. I don't even know if I need white Pikmin at all. I don't think there's any buried. Alrighty. Thank you. Okay. This shouldn't be too hard. This is a strategy that becomes more relevant later in the game. But sometimes it's best just to take one captain and walk through the entire cave if you can. Because that... Well, you can figure out where the enemies and the treasures are, but... will also trigger some of the hazards that appear later in the game, like falling rocks. They're basically just at the front of every corridor. Yeah. Something I tend to do is just go into a new cave at the very end of the day. That looks familiar. Also, ew, it's dirty. Rest floor already? One annoying thing they added in this game is... sometimes there are bugs that will come out of those nectar eggs, and they'll cause your Pikmin to go into a panic. Forget what exactly they're called. It's like Mitite or something. Ooh. You'd think they would have put flowers on this floor. Oh, there are, but only if you have less than 20. Ah, so I was... Uh-oh. I will try again. Yeah. Actually, I'm going to take one moment. Hopefully that should be good. Oh. There we go. Someone more skilled than I can get rid of these without the use of red Pikmin. Wow, another floor with no enemies. That looks familiar.
What are you staring at me?
What?
Come on, buddy. Here. Not on the desk.
Ah, there they are. Red Pikmin are almost kind of completely useless in this game. Those are even better later in the game when you can, when you're able to get sprays from, when you're able to get sprays from enemies, and, those enemies, and from the eggs. Yeah. That is another quality of life improvement. This is the final floor. Okay.
Oh, no.
Come on. I need to get my camera in order. Are you gonna roll? Guess not. I may have cut that one a little close, but it was fine. Anywhere? Hopefully there are. Yes, the tester love. Surely there are some eggs. Guess not. I think that'll be it for day three. There's not really enough time to do anything else. I'll probably continue and do day four, though, and then that'll be done for the night. It's not exactly morning. Jelly? Oh, that was quick. Yeah, there really wasn't much time to do anything. Since you can skip them in this game, I'm gonna bypass the end of day cutscenes.